नहीं मेरे इसमें भी
ग्रेड
नहीं
व्यू
आया।
तो अभी तक नहीं आया,
हाँ मेरे इसमें भी नहीं आ रहा है,
ग्रेड व्यू
केवल
तो
वो
अभी
अटेंडेंस
भी
पूरी
नहीं
आ
आया।
गई है। ओके सो आफ्टर लॉट्स ऑफ एफर्ट्स एंड सो मेनी ट्रबल्स वी आर बैक एट लीस्ट, सो लेट्स ट्राई टू कैरी ऑन एंड लेट अस लीव फॉर टुडे द टास्क ऑफ असाइनिंग चैप्टर्स टू यू। इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट लेट अस डू द नेक्स्ट और न्यू लेसन वॉट एवर वी हैव प्लान फॉर, बिकॉज ऑलमोस्ट 15-20 मिनट्स आर वेस्टेड, राइट? सो इंस्टेड ऑफ वेस्टिंग एनी फर्दर टाइम लेट्स गेट टू द लेसन्स एंड दिस थिंग वील डू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास। ओके एग्रीड?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
So what was the next lesson planned? We have recently finished Amanda, have we?
Yes, sir.
Amanda has been finished. Okay. Then what is next after Amanda?
The 100 lessons.
100
lessons. Yes. So I'll share 100 lessons. First of all, I'll have to find it out in my textbook section. Okay, then I'll share it with you. Just a moment. This is chapter number 5.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, somebody may read this first part before you read section, a little bit about what we are going to read here and this information given in the box, and then we'll come to the story. Okay,
sir,
I'll show something.
Sir,
more.
May I? Sir, may
I read?
Yes.
Sir, any? May I read?
Sir, may I?
Okay.
Sorry,
Sir, Arshit. Sir, Sachin.
Sir, Abhishek Bhargava.
Okay, Abhishek Bhargava, read.
Yes, sir. Chapter 5, the 100 dress, part 1. Before you read, first, how do you judge the people around us? By their money, wealth and possessions? Or is there something of more enduring value to look for in a person? This story is a sensitive account of how a poor young girl is judged by her classmates. Wanda Petronsky is a young police girl who goes to school with other American children in an American town. These other children see Wanda as a different in many ways. Can you guess how they treat her? Read the information in the box below. Find out more about this community or about a related topic from an encyclopedia or the internet. Encyclopedia or the internet.
Okay. Someone else may read this information in the box.
Sir, may I read?
Charu.
Sir,
Sachin.
Sachin.
The Polish American community in the United States. The first Polish immigrants arrived in America in 1608. But the largest wave of Polish immigration occurred in the early 20th century, when more than 1 million Poles migrated to the United States. The Polish state did not exist at that time, and the immigrants were identified according to their country of origin rather than to ethnicity. They were identified as Russian Poles, German Poles, and Austrian Poles. One of the most notable Polish American communities is in Chicago and its suburbs. So, Chicago is sometimes called the second largest Polish city in the world, next only to Warsaw, the capital of Poland. Polish Americans were sometimes discriminated against in the United States, as were the Irish, Italians, and Jews. According to the United States 2000 census, 67,414 Americans of age 5 years and older reported Polish as the language spoken at home, which is about 1.4% of the people who speak languages other than English, or 0.25% of the US population.
Okay. Good, Sachin and Abhishek. Thank you very much. Now, the very first question asked here, how do we judge the people around us? When you happen to come across somebody, when there is a person whom you don't know, and you see that person for the first time, how do you start judging that person? How do you start thinking about that person? What is the first thing that impresses you, or what is the first thing that makes you have an idea about that person? What is that?
Way of talking.
The cloth.
Huh?
Way of talking.
Way of talking. And?
Dresses.
Her behavior.
Dresses kaun
dekhte? Behavior, way of talking. Okay, fine, similar things. What else?
Dressing sense.
Dress up. The way that person is dressed. This is how
living sense. Living sense. Living sense.
Living sense. That is behavior. Okay. And
sense
anything else?
Humor.
Sense of humor. Okay. These are all secondary things, beta. What is the primary thing? First impression. Before you start talking to that person.
Wealth.
Sir, cloth.
Somebody said wealth, somebody said clothes.
Yes.
When you say wealth, you don't see his wealth. You can't see, check his wallet or his bank balance. Wealth means the kind of clothes he is wearing, that person is wearing, whether very expensive, whether cheap, what kind of clothes that person is wearing, or if that person is having some sort of ornaments or expensive shoes or other expensive accessories. This shows that he is wealthy or rich or poor or whatever. This is one thing that you want to say. And the second thing is his clothing up, how he dresses up. This is another way you judge. Now, by dress up, you come to a judgment, come to a conclusion that this person belongs to which particular area or region of the country. Sometimes it gives us a little idea about the person's religion or his faith or his own ideology. What kind of things does he put on? So this gives an idea about that person. Okay. Now, what are they saying? By their money, wealth, and positions, or is there something of more enduring value to look for in a person? Now, only possessions, only dress up, only his wealth or his richness or his the signs, symbols of his prosperity, these are the things that help us understand, realize what kind of a person that is? Or is there something else that helps us? Earlier you were talking about the person's behavior, the way he speaks, the way he carries himself, the way he behaves with others. Does he give respect to others or not? These are also some more few more things that we take into consideration. But the very first thing is external appearance only. Right? Students, are you all
yes,
there?
Sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm
yes, sir.
Disconnected again and again. So keep on speaking a little bit so that
yes,
I will. Okay, fine. Thank
okay,
you.
Sir.
Yes,
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 sir.
Now, this story is a sensitive account
yes,
of how a poor young girl is judged by her classmates. How do they judge? A girl goes to a school and she's not as rich as others. She is poor, and how are the other classmates judging her? Wanda Petronsky is a young Polish girl. Polish girl means coming from Poland, who goes to school with other American children in an American town. So from Poland, this girl has shifted to, emigrated to
America.
America, and there in an American school, she takes admission. She starts studying over there. Now, these American children, how do they treat, how do they behave with this girl who is not an American? These other children see Venda as different in many ways. If a person from some other country comes to you, joins your school, gets admission in your class, then definitely that person, that student, that child will look different from you, isn't it? Can you guess how they treat her? How would their treatment be? Will it be very kind? Will they be accepting her, adopting her? Or will they be treating her badly? Will they be teasing her? Will they be laughing at her? What kind of a treatment would they be giving to her? This is what you are expected to guess about. Now, some information. Okay, and what is that information about? Community. What is this? Find out more about this community. This community means the Polish ones. Okay, the first Polish immigrants arrived in America in 1608. So this was the time, early 17th century, very early 17th century. At that time, they started arriving or immigrating to America. But the largest wave of Polish immigration occurred in the early 20th century, when more than 1 million Poles migrated to the United States. Okay, this is little bit of history. The Polish state did not exist at that time, and the immigrants were identified according to their country of origin rather than to ethnicity. They were identified as Russian Poles, German Poles, and Austrian Poles. One of the most notable Polish American communities is in Chicago and its suburbs. So Chicago is sometimes called the second largest Polish city in the world, next only to Warsaw, the capital of Poland. Polish Americans were sometimes discriminated against in the United States, so they have also faced discrimination, as were the Irish, Italians, and Jews. According to the United States 2000 census,
667,414
Americans of age 5 years and older reported Polish as the language spoken at home, which is about 1.4% of the people who speak languages other than English, or 0.25% of the US population. So that means they are very small in number. They are yet not adopted. They are yet not accepted. And they are facing discrimination also in USA. So now, when you know the backdrop, all the background of this Polish society there in USA, when they started immigrating, and what is their number, or what is the percentage of people speaking that language, Polish language, and all, then if you start reading this story, probably you will understand it better. Now, there is one more thing that I should share with you. Is this thing visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Yes, sir.
sir. What is this?
The 100 of references. The 100 references.
It's a page of Wikipedia, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. If it is visible, can you see the picture of a book here?
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is the actual book, The 100 Dresses. This is the book from which these two parts of your textbook have been taken. Lesson 5 and Lesson 6, 100 Dresses, Part 1 and Part 2, it has been taken from this book. So what we are going to read is just an excerpt of this book. Okay? This was the book.
Yes.
Now, The 100 Dresses is a 1944 children's book by Eleanor S., illustrated by Louis Slobodkin. In the book, a young Polish girl named Wanda Petrowski goes to a school in an American town in Connecticut. where the other children see her as different and mock her. They make fun on her. They laugh at her. She lived in Boggins Height. She lived in Boggins Height. Okay? Remember this name. Peggy and Maddie are the two girls who often make fun of her by asking her the number of dresses she had. This is how they made fun of her. Every time they met her, they used to ask her a question, how many dresses she has. And at the end, both Maddie and Peggy apologized to her for their rude behavior. So what all has happened, how they made fun of this girl, and what happened that made them to apologize to her at the end of the story. This is what we are going to see in this. Now there is little plot summary also, because we have little time left. So I'll quickly read this plot summary and then we shall begin with the explanation of lesson in the next class. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
the book centers on Wanda Pedronsky. This girl is the main character in this book. A poor and friendless Polish American girl. Her teacher, although outwardly kind, puts Wanda in the worst seat in the classroom and does not say anything when her schoolmates tease her. So this was on the part of her teacher also, that first thing she made her sit at a place which was worst position, worst place in the class. Second thing, when her schoolmates and her classmates, they teased her, the teacher did not say anything to them also. One day after Wanda's classmates laugh at her funny last name. The name is also little bit different, little bit new and bit funny for those people who do not belong to that community. So obviously it was funny for them, and they Petronsky. So they made fun. They laughed at her surname. And the faded blue dress she wears to school every day. So she comes to school in one same dress almost every day. Wanda claims to own 100 dresses. Wanda claims to own 100 dresses. Funny last name. Wanda claims to own 100 dresses. Now, she comes to school in one single dress every day. And when asked how many dresses do you have, what does she say? She has 100 dresses all lined up in a closet in a worn down house. House was a very poor accommodation where only poor people lived. And she said that she has so many dresses, 100 dresses in a closet. This outrageous and obvious lie becomes a game. See, everybody realizes, everybody understands that this girl is lying. And when they realize that this girl is lying, what did they do? They made it a game by asking this question again and again. And the group of girls in her class, headed by Maddie and Peggy, mock and corner her every day before school, demanding that she described all of her dresses for them. Her father, John Petronsky, reveals that due to constant despise of his family, they must leave town. See, they decided to leave the town because this is how the children were misbehaving with her. She was not happy. And other people in that locality also, they did not treat them well. And so he decided to leave that place and go to a bigger place, bigger city. The teacher holds a drawing contest in which the girls are to draw dresses of their own design. Wanda enters and submits 100 beautiful designs. Her classmates are in awe of her talent and realize that these were her 100 dresses. The students who teased her feel remorse and want her to know this, but they are not sure how. They decide to write her a kind letter and send it to her old address, hoping the post office can forward it. Unfortunately, she has already moved away and does not realize she won the contest. Nevertheless, Venda's lovely nature and kind heart are revealed later when she tells the teacher to give the students her drawings. So she tells her teacher to give away all the drawings, those 100 superb paintings, superb drawings that she has made to all the children of her class. This was shown at last. Now see, we have seen the outline of the story, seen the summary of the story. This all is there in it, but it has been described very nicely by Al Basour. What is the name of the writer? Al Basour Esther. Okay, Al Basour Esther. So it has been very beautifully described by the writer by in that story, how they treated her, how she responded, and how at last she proves herself very kind by giving away all the dresses. But she was and whole family was forced to leave that place because of this kind of mistreatment by everybody. It is already time up because you have your next class, so I'm stopping it here, but in the next class we shall do it properly. Okay beta, anything that you wish to ask?
No sir.
Okay, fine. Due to this connectivity problem we couldn't carry on properly, but no problem, we'll do it in the next class. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So now, Sairam.
And what about the assigning of the chapter?
Lessons I will assign in the next class. Okay? I'll assign lessons, sir, in the next class. Okay, beta. So start leaving. I'll leave at last.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.